Today I'm going to use Monet's colors to make a sun-drenched still life because there's no sun outside today. Let's get started. So this is the colors that I decided to choose. And the reason for choosing this was, I don't know, it just seemed so Monet to me. And also wasn't a really recognizable painting to me. I mean, at first I thought I'll do the water lilies, and then I thought I would do the haystacks, and I thought, no, try to get away from something that's so iconic. So that's what I did, and I mixed up the colors that I found in this landscape. Wow. All I can say is there were no neutrals in this landscape. Not maybe the Naples yellow could be called a neutral, but barely. I mean, holy smokes. And the other thing I noticed was that there was no violet. That violet that seems to appear is not a violet. It's a rose that's mingled in with some cerulean blue in the little dabs, and it creates sort of a violet going on. But there's no actual violet used in this painting. So that was kind of a surprise. I wouldn't have known if I hadn't done the colors. The other thing that I noticed is, the other thing I was going to notice was in these exercises where I'm being a different artist and using their colors, I'm not using the same ratios, because that very bright orange, for example, reddish orange thing, only appears for a few dabs in his painting. So I'm not going for the same ratio that he used. I'm just going for the same colors that he used. And let's look at my first experiment. Now, my first experiment that I did, I didn't think came out very well, and that's why I'm going to share it with you. Not just that do I think I got the ratios wrong, but it's way weighted toward blue. And I don't think that's what he had in mind. I also think I went darker than he does. Not darker. What I should say is it just didn't feel right. It just didn't feel right looking at the two next to each other. So I did it again, because that's the kind of person I am. If I don't kind of get what I want the first time, I'm gonna go after it again. So I already had the colors mixed up, and this is kind of the process that I'm using. I'm using the same still life setup, and the whole point of this is that my still life setup is never gonna look like this in my studio, because that's not the light that I get in my studio. I live in Vermont. Monet was working in France. And he was outdoors, I'm indoors. I mean, there's no way I'm gonna get these same colors to appear in real life. So I'm kind of using them in order to create more varied still lifes than I would have if I was matching the color to what's happening in my studio. You can also see far off to the right, I bought some happy cups. I'm gonna be painting those soon. I have these happy cups, which are just a really nice size and color. I'm gonna have a lot of fun with those this winter. But back to the point. So the point is, I'm following with my finger, trying to figure out where the darks, mediums, and the lights are. I put in, these are the darkest darks that I'm gonna use. And I'm really just value painting right now. I already figured out the colors. And so now I just have to plug value into color. And you can see the Monet is far to the left. The picture that I'm painting from is the apple in the photograph. I have my resource of the colors that I painted nearby. And I also have far up on the right-hand corner a little place where I can do some test dabs if I haven't hit it correctly. You'll see in pencil next to those little dabs that I made, or the square dabs, I mean, the recipe, because I needed to remember the recipe as I went along, because these are not colors that I would normally use. So I just jotted down really quickly how to make these colors. I'm not buying any new tubes of paint. That's not what this is about at all. This is about finding how much variety can I get out of the current tubes of paint that I have, and how can I make my work in general more varied, because I got in a rut of just kind of doing this, going to comfortable triads and comfortable patterns. And the whole point of this is to try to break out of this and see where it can lead. I think I'm going to do Winslow Homer next. Wow, I love that apple. I just love the color of that apple. Whoa. Now, of course, Monet was working with tiny, tiny dabs, and my point was not to replicate his style. That's not what I'm trying to do here. I'm trying to replicate the color and perhaps the feel. I mean, there's a lot of warmth in that painting. It's almost like two separate paintings. One is cool with those darker greens and blues, and then the other side is quite warm. I probably didn't use as much yellow as he does, but that's okay. Like I said, I wasn't going for the same ratio. Now, as I said, there was no violet, so I didn't mix up any violet. What I did was I put down a rose and then a cerulean nearby it, just like what he had done way far back in the mountains, in order to get some of those that lighter shadow that I just did. And now I'm working around the apple, and I want to put some green near the apple because that's going to make that red pop a little bit. So if there's an opportunity to kind of play with color, I'm going to do that too, especially if I can put a complementary color near another color. That's going to just make a little bit more depth. And I do think this painting has more depth than the first one that I did. I also think that it's truer in terms of the colors. This was, that's pretty close to being wrong there. That cobalt is really standing out to me, and I don't think he used cobalt in that painting at all. Again, this is a reproduction, you know, coming off the my screen, and then it's reproduced on a print coming from my printer, so who knows what the real colors are. And that doesn't matter either. The whole point was to have a different still life than I would normally have, and I definitely have a different still life than I would normally have. I can't believe I didn't use any alizarin crimson in this painting at all. How could I paint an apple with no alizarin crimson? I have to admit there's a bit of a cheat on that apple stem. I couldn't find a correct color for the apple stem. It's happening somewhere in those trees to the left, but I couldn't determine what it was, and I decided to give myself a pass. So there you can see all the resources for how I got to what I'm now calling my Monet still life, which I'm happy with this one, so I can move on. Like I said, I think I'm going to move on to Winslow Homer. The colors are going to get way darker and way grayer because we're leaving the south of France and going into the Adirondacks in the fall in the United States. So, boy, are those colors going to be different. But red will show up, as it always does in Winslow Homer. So remember to keep the whites of your paper white, your paints wet, mask for value, mix for color, and join my YouTube channel, and I'll see you next time. Okay, bye-bye.